welcome to my channel, The Pharmacy World. This video is about medical terminology. So this will definitely help all the students of PharmD, medical as well as nursing field, probably the first year PharmD. If you want to know more about my channel, you can check the description given down below. Also guys, watch the video till the last. You will be finding an amazing question waiting for you. I have also mentioned the links regarding the PharmD syllabus, including all the years. So let's get started. So guys, firstly we should understand what is medical terminology. It is a language where the medical terms are used by the healthcare professionals to describe the human body regarding its components, processes, procedures and conditions by communicating with each other. Medical terms are formed from two or more word parts, which may be a root word, prefix, suffix or a combining form. So root word represents the main part containing the basic meaning. Prefix is attached to the beginning of the word, suffix is attached to the end of the word, and the combining form enables two word parts connected. You don't have to worry about memorizing these word parts. The easy trick to memorize these medical terms is to know the exact meaning of the word. So this video will help you fix this problem. So guys, the first term is algia, which is pain. You can see the picture on your right side representing an old lady suffering from pain. When you hear this word algia, this picture has to come to your mind. The common examples include arthralgia, the joint pain, mastalgia, the breast pain, myalgia, the muscle pain, neuralgia, the nerve pain. Here the prefix changes the entire meaning of the word. The next term is angio, which means vessels. This may be a blood or a lymphatic vessel. You can see a cartoonic picture of a vessel on your left side, which means whenever you just hear the word angio, this picture has to come into your mind. Examples may include angioectasis, the dilation of a blood vessel, angialgia, the pain in the blood vessel, angiectomy, surgery to remove a part of a blood vessel, angioplasty, an embryonic tissue where the blood vessels arises. Here the ectasis means dilation, algia, pain, ectomy where the surgery is done, angioplast, an embryonic tissue where the blood vessel is arised. The next term is arthro, which means joints. Whenever you just hear the word arthro, this picture representing the type of joints present in the human body should come into your mind. Coming to the examples, arthralgia, which means the joint pain, arthritis, the joint inflammation, arthrostasia, the sensation in the joint surfaces, arthrosis, I'll talk you about it later, arthropathy, any disease of a joint. So guys, arthrosis is one of the form of arthritis, which is also known as osteoarthritis. So when it comes to the difference between the arthritis and arthrosis, arthritis is the inflammation of a joint, whereas the arthrosis is non-inflammatory degeneration of a joint. So here the majorly affected part is the cartilage. Why? Because the joint is formed by the fibrous connective tissue under cartilage. Next is the term emia, which is blood. Common examples include anemia, the lack of RBC or the hemoglobin in the blood, phosphatemia, the presence of phosphate ions in the blood, natremia, the presence of sodium ions in the blood, hypovolemia, the low volume of blood, leukemia, the blood cancer, uremia, the presence of blood in the urine. Anemia is a very good example to keep this medical term remember. Next is the term ache, which is pain that is persistent. The common examples include headache, stomach ache, toothache and earache. Next is a quite important medical term, apnea, related to breath. So when this word is being used, you have to get this picture into your mind where the boy is having difficulty in breathing and having a nebulizer. So the examples are dyspnea, orthopnea and platypnea. So dyspnea refers to difficulty in breathing. Orthopnea refers to difficulty in breathing when a person is in lying position, that is flat position. And platypnea refers to shortness of breath when a person is in standing or sitting position. Do not get confused between orthopnea and platypnea. Just keep in mind, ortho means flat position, platy means standing or sitting position. The next term is asthenia. So A is for without and sthenia is for strength. So asthenia means weakness. Whenever you just hear the word asthenia, you should get this picture into a mind where the girl is feeling low in energy and feeling tired. So the common examples are myasthenia, which means the loss of muscle strength, as in myasthenia gravis. So myasthenia gravis is a condition where there is an interruption in the transmission of nerve impulses to the muscle, which causes weakness in the muscles. Neurasthenia, the weakness of the nerves. Thrombasthenia, which is the bleeding disorder due to weak platelets. So in this condition, the platelets contain low level of glycoprotein, which is the receptor of fibrinogen. So fibrinogen is a protein which is essential for the clot formation. In this condition, due to the low level of glycoprotein, instead of clot formation, bleeding occurs. The next term is baro, which means pressure. So this picture of a boy having his blood pressure test done should come into your mind whenever you just hear the medical term baro. So the examples are baroreceptors. So these baroreceptors are sensors. They sense the blood pressure. These are also known as pressoreceptors. Since they are located in the carotid sinus and aortic arch, they can sense the blood pressure, relay the information to your brain, and this blood pressure can be maintained without any fluctuations. Next is the term blepharo, which means eyelid. Common examples include blepharitis, the inflammation of eyelids, blepharoplasty, a plastic surgery done to correct the defects regarding the eyelids, blepharospasm, which is the eyelid muscle contraction, blepharoedema, which means the swelling of the eyelids. So you can see the picture on the right side where a boy is having swelling of the eyelids. So whenever you just hear the word blepharo, this picture showing the swelling of eyelids should come into your mind. When you hear the word blepharo, this picture where a boy is having his eyelids swollen should come to your mind. Next is the term brady, which is slow. The common examples include bradycardia, the slow heart rate, bradypnea, the slow breathing rate, bradykinesia, the slow movement. So when you hear the word brady, this picture representing a girl walking slowly to her house or a school should come to your mind. So guys, you can imagine it in your own way. Next is the term blast, which are the immature cells. They are also known as precursor cells or stem cells. So these immature cells give rise to all kinds of different specialized cells. So the common examples are amyloblast, the precursor cell involved in the formation of tooth enamel, whereas the osteoblast, the immature cell from which the bone is formed. Next is the term coli, which is related to bile. So bile is a fluid produced by the liver. So from the picture on your right side, it clearly explains that the bile is produced from the liver. So bile helps in digestion of lipids in the small intestine. So the common examples are cholecystokinin, cholecystitis and cholangitis. So cholecystokinin is the hormone which stimulates the release of bile into the intestine. So guys, in cholecystitis, the gallstones block the tube from which the bile flows from gallbladder to small intestine. So this results in bile building up and causing the inflammation. Whereas the cholangitis is the inflammation of the bile duct system. So guys, that's the end of the video, and a lot of effort has been put to make this video up. So if you like this video, please do like, share, comment and subscribe, and also hit the bell icon so that you will be notified for my upcoming videos. Also guys, leave your comments regarding guess the drug name